Hey, what's going on, guys? It's your boy Sal here from freestockpicks.org. Freestockpicks.org, so many domains sometimes forget. Anyway, I'm making this quick video because I want to talk about my time at John Thomas Financial. John Thomas Financial, if you haven't already looked in Wikipedia, got shut down by the SEC. I guess the owners were doing something, and the other older brokers were doing something fishy. We all got shut down. We were basically a boiler room. And I wasn't there for too long. I wasn't there toward the end when they actually got shut down. But that's where I got my start in penny stocks. That's where I learned about penny stocks and the world of investing in small cap companies, micro cap companies. And I dove 100% into it, man. It was just something that I loved to do. I didn't really like the idea of calling random people who, you know, for all intents and purposes, could care less about what we were doing and trying to beg them and convince them to invest with us. I thought that what I'm doing, my strategy of just reaching out to the world and reaching out to people who believe in what I'm doing, those people will, you know, gravitate towards me and participate in some of the things that we're doing. And that's what I like to do on here. But at John Thomas Financial, I remember the process of getting in. It was online. It was on Craigslist. I had just showed up in New York. My dream was to become a municipal bonds trader after I had graduated. And after I graduated that December, I went to New York to live with my sister. I was living in the basement. I'm not actually in the basement, on the living room floor, basically. And then she bought a sofa because she had just moved there not too long before me. And while living in the living room, I was checking, you know, signing up for basically every position that was available out there. And sure enough, this opportunity at John Thomas Financial came up. It was on Craigslist. And I signed up. I sent a resume. I got a call back in like 10 minutes. So a guy with a British accent called me up. And he's like, you know, we have the opportunity for junior brokers and we want you to come in. So I come in and, you know, I gave them my whole spiel, you know, school, education, my resume, job, you know, skills, whatever. So he gives me, a call sheet, basically, you know, say this, and then I say it, and I say it so wonderfully, they were just like, oh my God, this guy's awesome. So basically they offered me the job right there. I mean, the interview process was 10 minutes. There were a bunch of other people there. And, you know, this guy's telling us how we can make, you know, $500,000 this year if we really want to. And, you know, did I believe him? Yes and no. Yes, because I was desperate enough to believe him because I had been there now in New York almost 3.5 weeks. I didn't get a single call. And I was kind of, I was edgy and I wanted to make an opportunity for myself in New York City. So I took the job. It's one of those jobs where you have to show up to work every single day dressed up, suit and tie. And man, I spent like $700, you know, at these cheap little, you know, Arab suit and tie stores getting all type of just cheap Chinese made crap. But anyway, I looked sharp going to work every day, and then you have to put in a couple weeks where you're just kind of trying it out. And you have to stand on your feet, by the way. You're not allowed to sit down, just like the movie Boiler Room. I mean, it was really, really like that. I wasn't allowed to sit down. What else? I basically couldn't sell. I could only basically pitch. And then once I got the client hooked, I'd pass it on to a senior broker. And it was bullshit. I got frustrated with the idea of getting people, you know, hooked and then giving my lead away to somebody who wasn't going to close the way I closed, wasn't going to be able to establish the kind of communication that I did in that 3 or 4 minutes that we've been able to you know, get this guy to listen to us, you know? And I felt that I could take my passion, my skills, and bring it to YouTube, you know, bring it in a way that I don't need to go out and get a broker's license. I don't need to go out and get all that crap and bring it to the world and attract the people who really, really believe in what I'm doing and want to become a part of it. So I'm glad I left John Thomas Financial. I quit. I didn't even let them know I was quitting. I just never went back. And it's so funny because they didn't even realize I was gone because I got a call back like 3 days later. Guy left a voicemail. Hey, where are you? I haven't seen you in a while. And then they never called back because, you know, it seemed like every day we were getting new guys, and guys were disappearing all the time. But I enjoyed being on the phone. I'd done that when I sold cars at Chrysler for a little bit one summer. So, but it really was a kind of churn and burn kind of place that boiler rooms are. I don't know if there are still any boiler rooms. There are still some boiler rooms out there, but in New York City, I don't know. But how they were able to afford, you know, right smack dab in on Wall Street, just off the 4 train in Manhattan. It was a nice office too. The bathroom had a butler service. I mean, there was this, I felt sorry for this brother because he was an older guy, maybe late 60s, but I remember one afternoon, we all went into the restroom after lunch, and these guys were just blowing themselves a second asshole. I mean, they were just really just taking a shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, and this guy's just standing in there, you know, just, I don't know. I just was like, man, I don't know how you do this for a living, but it was he was the bathroom butler. Anyway, I'm going off track here. I just want to give you guys a sense of how life was at John Thomas Financial. If you don't know the story about it, just go Google it. It's on Wikipedia. The owner was John Blessimus or whatever. I only met the guy like 3 times while I was there. Anyway, this is your boy Sal, freestockpicks.org. Just kind of want to give you a little runaround of how I got started in all this. More videos to come. Freestockpicks.org. Sign up to the newsletter if you haven't already. Take care.